Hey guys, what's going on? And welcome to a new Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2 video. In this video, I am going to be actually mastering the power cactus in one day. So here's the power cactus. This is a voiceover, by the way, so this was pre-recorded content. So if anything is kind of like off, or if, you know, anything is a little bit different or slow or anything, that's why. But I did get the power cactus mastered. This is the power cactus, and shoots like that. Pretty normal shooting. It's a cactus that, you know, you shoot and it like damages things around it as well. So it doesn't just damage one thing. It also has the mines, the potato mine ability. You guys probably know about that. And the wall ability. You place a wall and then the garlic gin as well. But let's get on to the games. So game one was a pretty short game, but I got my first kill, as you guys can see. I also got a little cheeky kill, as you guys can see in the bottom left. And I got a few more kills as well, but I also got level 2, obviously. But that was my first level, and I tried to dance, but, you know, dancing always leads to death, like the song. But, yeah, after that, I got another cheeky kill, you know, in there. And then everything was going great until this dude came along. So, yeah, that was pretty much game one. But hey, you know, at least we lost, you know, because that's just great. In these first games, you guys will start to develop or see a pattern in my skill. It starts to get a little bit better, but I'm actually in my living room on a big TV, so there's a huge delay. So yeah, that's why I wasn't playing that well at the beginning. But I'll go from like getting 1 to 2 kills and dying to then getting like 4 kills and dying. If 4 to 5, maybe 6, and then dying later on. So I'm getting better at the character. But that's my first drone kill right there. And, you know, dying isn't that bad because I placed down some potato mines right there. And as you guys can see, I still killed somebody and somehow got level 3. I also got some more drone kills, some more potato mine kills, and also some more potato mine kills and leveling up. But that was pretty much game 2 complete. Now for game 3, I have the cactus stretching for 12 minutes because I left and went AFK. So let's just count that one out. As I get later in the game, I was starting to get better at these long range kind of snipes like this, for example. And yeah, eventually I leveled up to level 5. I also started using my dark artichoke that I actually bought a while back and never really used. But as I used this airstrike, I surprisingly killed 2 people, which was, I was really surprised. So, you know, I had to do my victory dance. And go figure, the zombies won again. You'll see a pattern. After starting off game 5 with 1 clueless kill, 2 clueless kills, and then me being clueless myself, the game was pretty good, other than that last part. But, yeah, I don't think this guy should have killed me, but, yeah, okay. I even got to fuse a bomb, which ended up actually being the winning bomb. Yeah, that was a lie, I died immediately. How did this dude kill me? And then after getting 2 kills with the garlic drone, we eventually reached level 6, and that was the end of the game. Hey, and I actually got assist master. At least it's something. And then in game 6, after dying to some dark magic, killing the guy who killed us with dark magic, which is a pretty clean shot, and killing this other dude who was also clueless that I lasered, holy crap, and then killing imps, which I actually realized are really, really easy to kill with this character. If you want to kill some imps, play as this. And then I killed this guy. He was very clueless as well, but he was low, so I think the barrel was his only hope, to be honest. And then after some precise potato mine planting and a imp spinning, we eventually reached level 7. I said level 7. And then we got this kill, which really didn't make any sense, because I killed him, and look, we got a mech kill. And then for this chemist, yeah, I don't really feel bad. I mean, it's a chemist. And as I rushed these group of zombies, I realized that I should probably never rush a group of zombies ever again. And yeah, another harsh loss, but who cares? We're leveling up the cactus. Game 7 was a pretty good game, especially for when I killed a guy and saved my whole entire team. I also killed this guy, which I kind of felt bad for. This guy. And this guy, but I was starting to get a little bit ahead of myself. And I died a horrible death. Stupid computer scientists ruined my streaks. Oh wait, we're level 8. The rest of the level was pretty much a blur, other than killing this guy. This guy. This guy. And eventually, I had another 4 streak. Oh, Jesus Christ. Hey, well, at least we won this time. Game 8 was also a pretty interesting one. After getting some early on kills, also killing some zombies that were in our base because we were in Gnome Bomb, it was going pretty well. Other than this guy, you'll see me die to this guy a lot. Never mind. I also got revenge on the computer scientist from last game. And I also killed this guy, which I actually kind of feel bad for. And hey, before you know it, the game is actually over. Oh no, not this again. And hey, I even got Vanquish Streak Master. It's pretty cool. Game 9 was actually an amazing game for me, because I actually got a 16 kill streak. I'll let you guys watch the rest. And after a while of killing, I finally reached level 10, the first prestige. But you thought that was all? And that was pretty much that game. I mean, hey, we still lost, but at least I got Vanquish Streak Master and Assist Master. And there we have it, Power Cactus is now specialist. 20% of the way done. Dear Lord. Game 10 was also a good one. Starting off with some early kills, or should I say late kills, because we started at the end of the game. I actually switched to Turf Takeover to try to get some more XP. And just like that, we had a 3 streak. And then came more clueless engineers. My god, engineers are so clueless in this video. My god. And after one more pretty nice drone kill in the engineer, the game is over. And we lost. Go figure. Game 11 was also a good one, but I found myself doing this a lot, which was unfortunate. Starting the game off with a couple of drone kills, and getting a little bit too confident, and my drone died. But hey, what is going on here? After hitting some very precise shots on this foot soldier, and then getting an easy shot on this all-star, we eventually reached specialist level 4. And then killed another clueless engineer, and another clueless engineer, and then died to the clueless engineer. The game was over, and we actually won. I also got assist master. I'll be counting these up for you guys at the end of the video. Game 12 was also a pretty good one. I started out the game with a kill, which actually led me straight to level 5. I also started to learn how the electric power really works and how to use it correctly, but the electric power doesn't save you all the time, and yeah, I still suck at the game. After getting a couple more nice kills, I was starting to realize I was actually getting a lot better with this character. I mean, just look at this. Assist, 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 you get the point. But you know, I can't be that mad at the assist, because this one got me to level 6. And then came another 8 kill long streak. You guys can watch the rest. We'll be right back. god. It was just then I started realizing I was getting really good at getting streaks back up. Like, I was getting like 3 streaks so fast. Like, look, watch. Boom, boom. Level 7, dude. Too easy. After realizing that I had all these character upgrades that I never used for leveling up, I went back into the game and got a few more good kills. Now this is what I call a good use of electricity. Dude, did you see that? He went flying! Then there was a huge shield fest, where we killed that guy, and then this guy came over to revive him, and we killed that guy, and then this guy came over to revive him, and we killed that guy, but he revived that guy, and then that guy turned around and started shooting at me, and survived on one health! Now this part was really fun, because all this snow was in the way, and I was getting so many kills. I mean, look how much XP I was getting, and I even got a mech vanquish. But after getting a few more kills with a 6 streak, I eventually died. Oh yeah, and I leveled up to level 8. I accidentally ran into a huge group of zombies, so I just spammed down a bunch of potato mines, placed a wall, died, and still somehow killed someone. I also just started to realize how overpowered this drone was. I mean, boom, kill, until I died with it. I'm starting to think I'm gonna get more kills when I'm dead than when I'm alive. But other than this kill, and me leveling up from this guy to level 9, and also getting a new upgrade, the reload upgrade that really helped, the game was pretty much over. And we lost. Cause why wouldn't we? After getting some really nice shots on these foot soldiers on the last game, and then also killing the last foot soldier, which got us finally to level 10. This meant we can go back to the backyard and prestige our character. Right after I died to the scuba soldier and kill him from beyond the grave. Ah, good advanced. I could practically taste master already. After taking about an hour break, I was ready to come back and get some more kills. And thanks to the drone, I was able to get my first kill as advanced and then die. At this point, I was starting to get so used to this cactus, I was even getting good at a close range, and I eventually got level 2. After I got 2 more really, really clean foot soldier kills, I started to realize that my skill with cacti, or this character in general, was starting to go up. I was going from 1 to 2 kills and dying to like 3 to 4, which is good. Boom. Boom. Yes, I just got 2 goop kills. And yes, I feel really bad. Honestly, I deserve to get jump shotted. A little bit later, I got a few more kills with the drone, and eventually unlocked level 5. Getting kills with this drone may be a little bit hard, but when you're going against people like this, it's pretty easy. And that was game, and finally, we won. But whoa, what is happening on the right side of the screen? Game 14 is a really short one, because the only thing I had enough time to do was die. And yeah, that was the end of the game. Game 15 was an interesting one. I started it off with a kill on an imp, but also I started it off with a horrible, horrible death. You'll be seeing that name a lot. I'm pretty sure that guy was Superman, but, you know, he wasn't strong enough to kill me. After I gave my teammate a quick res, I eventually reached level 6. Finally, it was all downhill from here. Until this guy joined the lobby and hit me in the next week. Yeah, remember when I said about Superman? This is the real Superman. I'm a power cactus, he's a toxic brains, you know what happens next. You wanna know the good thing about potato mines? The good thing is, you never know when you're gonna get a kill. Yeah. But after killing Superman, finally, we eventually got to level 7. And Superman's sidekick. I didn't know you could kill Superman more than once, but this shot was amazing. Here's another great example of how to use the electricity in this game. I got one more clean kill, and that was game. Game 16 was actually very uneventful, but I started out the game with a hipfire kill. Also, I got a very easy kill on a foot soldier, and ended up getting level 8. And yeah, that was literally the end of the game. Very short one. Just when I thought I was leveling up slow, I went into the next game and eventually got first strike. From this point on, I was starting to get very good at sniping with this character. Let me just show you guys some clips. Okay, that's all. What? Eventually, I came across this goat and killed him, which then got me to level 9. And also, it got me a zoom upgrade, which will help later. And right as I thought I could get this guy to level 10, I shot a few more shots, but the game had ended. Hey, at least I got first strike. After all those games, I was honestly starting to get bored of Turf Takeover, so I decided I would go switch over to Mixed Mode. But I was on Great West North anyway. My first kill was on this engineer, and it was actually really, really easy compared to the last game. I also killed this scientist as my second kill, expected more from a computer scientist. While on my journey, I unfortunately got shot by a scientist, but it made it up when I got a kill from beyond the groove. And boom. Just like that, I was level 10 and elite. Instead of waiting, I just left the game. I didn't feel like it. And here we are, for the third time, leveling up my only ever cactus to elite. Promotions, power cactus, and promoted to elite. None of my other cacti are promoted to elite or above. So this was amazing. Let's keep going. I started game 19 at the very end of a Zombopolis map, also killing a AFK Superbrains.
Yo.
I also killed a goop zombie, which I actually kind of felt bad. But mostly during the game, I was trying to destroy this battery for the objective, which was kind of annoying. But yeah, we still lost anyway, as you guys can see. Game 20 started off with a quick imp kill that actually led me to level 4 of elite, as you guys can see right there. I also tried rushing people more as this cactus, just because I felt like I wasn't leveling up quick enough, and I was leveling up very, very slow at the time. So I tried it, and it actually worked. I was leveling up at an astonishing rate. Never mind. After a few more quick kills, I killed one more imp, and that got me to level 5. I also got a damage upgrade that I didn't use until the end, because I'm an idiot. Other than killing some more clueless engineers, nothing really happened that game. Other than this. This is pure toxicity. I almost forgot. I also killed a scientist and got level 6. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. I also got a first strike. I had no clue and it wasn't in the video. And I saw no footage. So, yeah. Let's just go on in the next game. Game 21 started out with an easy scientist kill. Another pretty easy scientist kill. And an extremely easy all-star kill. From this point forward, I was actually starting to enjoy using the power cactus, as I actually knew how to use its ability in its, like, you know, own little special way, and I was actually really enjoying it. Once I walked back into the center, I met up with a bunch of zombies. I killed 1, 2, and 3 zombies to get level 7. Other than a couple more easy drone kills, that was game 21 complete. Game 22 started out very late in the Zombopolis map again, but I did start off the game with an early drone kill, an early regular kill, and some terrible deaths. And then, thanks to an assist, I reached level 8 and died. And that was game. A very short one, but go figure we lost. Game 23 was also a very short game, but it started off with a really weird trade. Didn't get first strike though. I honestly let this guy get the kill because he deserved it so much and he fell off the edge. He just stood there and yeah, I really wanted to give him the kill. But with the last kill on this imp, I finally reached level 9. Oh, that's game. Game 24 started off with me being in a drone, and it actually seemed to work because I got 2 assists and I was level 9. I also started getting a lot of snipes like this, and yeah, I was starting to work on my sniping skills, other than when I missed every shot on the scientist. I was also hitting a lot of shots on this all-star, and I thought I was doing pretty good at that time. But yeah, that was that game, and it was pretty fun. Game 25 also started really well. I got a quick kill on an engineer, and I also got a quick kill on this Z-Mech. I was at a 4 streak, which was not bad to start off the game. And I was doing pretty well, I thought. But then the scientist came along, and I killed him, and boom, I was level 10. And for the second to last time, 80% complete, we have the Power Cactus at Super Elite. That rhymed. Wow. Okay. Well, there you go. Oh my god. Let's keep going. Game 26 also started pretty well. I got 2 kills right off the bat. I also got a pretty nice drone kill on this all-star. And I also got a pretty nice shot on this imp as well. By that time, I killed 1 coffin zombie, and I was level 3. Later on, I also got a pretty easy kill on this guy. And then another easy kill on that foot soldier, getting me to level 4. After getting a few more kills, I was finally really close to level 5, and I killed this imp to get to level 5. Dang, we're leveling up really fast. And that was pretty much game. I don't know how we did it, but we did it somehow. Game 27 was a short but really great game. I started off with first strike. I also got some kills here and there, but I also got some ones on some very, very unusual people. I also got a really, really clutch kill on this scientist. Just hit firing him and somehow killed him. And later on, all I had to do was res a teammate, and boom, level 6. And that's game 27 for you. We won it. Oh yeah, and I also got Killmaster and First Strike, so that's cool. Game 28 started with a very, very simple imp kill. I also learned to always place potato mines. And after I did something, I reached level 7. I finished the game with the second to last kill, and that was pretty much the game. I also got Assist Master, which is also pretty cool. Game 29 started out in a drone, and I got a pretty nice scientist kill. I also got a few more kills with the electric, and by the way guys, in the background if you ever hear a voice, it's my chat during the stream. I thought I could get this character level 8, but the game ended too quick. And that was it. We lost. Go figure. I started out game 30 with a quick drone kill, which actually led me straight to level 8. I also got to fuse a bomb, another one, which was actually really cool. I didn't really get to do it that much. And I also got a really, really clutch kill right after I did that. I was so close to death. I figured since I haven't put on any customizations that I would start putting on customizations. And this is my final product. What do you guys think? I also got a really nice hit fire shot on this all-star, making me reach level 9. And that was pretty much game. And oh wait, oh no, for the last time. Uh-oh. Game 31, the last game. Alright, we started off with a pretty good kill. I'm gonna say that. We also got another kill like that, and still I'm not good at the game, forgot. One crazy thing is that this last game literally involved everything, even a potato mine kill. And 3, 2, 1, boom, level 10, guys. Oh my god, we did it in the video. Guys, this has been a crazy, crazy thing. I would have never thought I would have been able to do this. This has been one of the most crazy challenges I think I've ever done. The challenge itself wasn't that bad, but guys, let me tell you this. I spent 4.5 hours playing games, right? The live stream is on my YouTube channel, and then another 2.5 hours before that. So, overall, it's probably about, like, 6-7 hours, somewhere around there, playing as the character, and I just spent at least 3-4 hours editing this. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Please leave a like. This was so hard to make. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. And I guess I'll talk to you guys later. I'm going to do the stats at the end. All the coins. All like the first strikes and everything. And you guys will see that in a little bit. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye, guys.